In this video, we talk about network layer routing logics. First of all, we will look into how to send an IP packet across subnets at the host level and then at the router level. Finally, we will sum up our video with the keynotes. In this example, we will use this network diagram. First of all, we logged into PC1 and pinged the IP address of PC2. As you know, the ping command will generate ICMP message, which is encapsulated into an IP packet on PC1. And here is the content of the IP packet. It has a source IP is the IP address of PC1 and the destination IP is the IP address of PC2. The protocol field tells us that the next layer protocol is Internet Control Message Protocol. Now, in order to forward the IP packet to PC2, the network layer of PC1 determines that the IP address of PC2 is in a different subnet, so it has to forward the packet to its default gateway. In order to forward the packet to the default gateway, PC1 has to check in its cache table to see if there is any entry mapping between the IP address of the default gateway with the MAC address. In this case, let's assume that there's no entries found, so PC1 have to use the app protocol to find the MAC address associated with the IP address of the default gateway, and it finds the MAC address of the interface E10 on router 1. Now it encapsulates the IP packets into the Ethernet frame. Because this is the Ethernet network, and here is the content of the Ethernet frame. It has a source MAC address, which is a MAC address of PC1, and the destination MAC address, which is the MAC address of the interface E10 on router 1. And now it sends the Ethernet frame to router 1. So the forwarding logics at the host level is to forward the packet to the default gateway when it sends the packet to a different subnet. As soon as the Ethernet frame arrives at router 1, router 1 sees that the destination MAC address is the MAC address of its interface E10, so it will process the frame. First, it checks the frame check sequence field in the trailer of the frame to see if there is any errors. If it finds any errors, then it will discard the entire frame. In this case, let's assume it doesn't find any errors, so it will de-encapsulate the header and the trailer of the frame to get the IP packet. Then it finds the destination IP from the header of the packet. In this case, the destination IP is the IP address of PC2. Then it checks with its routing table and it finds this matching route. It follows the instruction in this routing entries to forward the packet to the destination IP 10.0.0.2. out via the interface serial 20. Now router 1 knows that it has to forward the packet out via the serial interface, so it has to encapsulate the packet into an HDLC frame. Then it forwards the HDLC frame out via the interface S20. As soon as the HDLC frame arrives at router 2 via the interface S20, because the interface S20 is a serial interface, so router 2 knows that the frame is for itself, so it will process the frames. First, it checks the frame check sequence field in the chowder of the frame to see if there is any errors. In this case, let's assume it doesn't find any errors, so it will de-encapsulate the frame to get the IP packet. Then it reads the destination IP from the header of the IP packet. In this case, the destination IP is the IP address of PC2. Now, router 2 checks with its routing table and it finds a matching route. From the matching route, router 2 knows that the destination network is directly connected via the interface E10. Now, router 2 knows that the destination network is an Ethernet network, so it has to find the MAC address associated with the destination IP using the app process. Then it encapsulates the IP packet into a new Ethernet frame. As you can see, this is the Ethernet frame and the source MAC address is the MAC address of the interface E10 on router 2 and the destination MAC address is the MAC address of PC2. However, the source and the destination IP stay the same. Now router 2 readies to send the frame via the interface E10 and it sends the frame to PC2 to end the routing process. Let's sum up our video with the keynotes. Host encapsulates all IP packets destined to a different subnet in data link layer frames, then forwards the frames to its default gateway. The default gateway is usually a router. When a frame arrives at a router interface, the network layer of the router processes with the following steps. First, the frame check sequence field is used to verify data integrity. The frame can only be processed in the next steps if no errors found. Otherwise, it is discarded. Next, the network layer strips out the old data link header and chowder to process the IP packet. After verifying the IP packet is good, it extracts the destination IP. It then searches in its routing table to see if any routes containing the destination IP. If found, this route is used to identify the outgoing interface of the router and possibly the next hop IP address of the router. Finally, it determines the source and destination physical address corresponding to the outgoing interface, then encapsulates the IP packet inside a new data link header and chowder and forward the frame, which ends the routing process. This is the end of this video. Thank you very much for watching.